This is going to be a nice and easy flow practice, just designed for those days when you wake up and the body might be a little sore from something you may have done the previous couple days. I'm going to give cues what feels good on my body, but as always, be mindful of what feels good on your body and make those adjustments as we go through the practice. We might spend an extra breath or two in certain poses, just as a way just to let the body relax a little bit. I'll give different variations depending on what you might be feeling and your body might want to get out of the practice. But if you have a block, that would be handy. If you don't have a block, we can get by without it. But let's just go ahead and start on our backs. So just come to the back, you bend the knees, bring the feet down. Hands can be anywhere you like them, on the chest, on the ribs. You can just let them hang down. Hands hang down by my side, but I'm gonna turn my palms up. It always feels a little bit better on my shoulders. Plus it lost the body, just to open up a little bit on the front. Nice easy breath in through the nose. And easy breath back out through the nose. Just feel the breath enter, running the length of the spine. As you exhale, feel it just returning back up the length of the spine, back out through the nose. Each inhale, feel the belly rise. Feel the chest lift. And each exhale, the belly will fall, the chest will fall. Take another deep breath. And then bring the hands next to the body, palms down, keep the feet where they are. If you want to actually, you can toe heel them a little bit closer together. And we're just going to rock the body right and left. Not really left and right, but we'll wind up in the same place. As we're rocking the body right and left, just maintain that same integrity of the breath. So in through the nose, no rush, and back out through the nose. Do it a couple more times each way. Back up to center. Take a breath here. And then bring the right ankle to the top of the left thigh. So ankle to knee pose. And then with that left knee, just try to bring the knee a little closer to the shoulder. Reach the hand, right hand through the leg. You can grab on the back of the shin. Or if it feels good, you can grab on the back. Take a few breaths here in and out. Sometimes on practices like these, I just like to close my eyes. Good. Take another breath in. And release that long. Just take the toes long, take the arms long. It's a nice big stretch before waking up. Inhale, and then exhale, nice and easy. Come back to that bridge position, but this time left ankle, right thigh. Bring the right thigh a little closer to the right shoulder, and then reach the left hand between the legs. Either grab the back of the thigh or front of the leg, whatever feels good. And a couple breaths here in. And out. big stretch, breathe into the upper part of the ribs. And come back up. Now here, you can bend the left knee. But bring the right foot up like we're going into a half happy baby. And take the hand, just grab on the inside of the heel. Now, if this feels like it's too much rotation on the hip, you can always grab the outside. That takes you to a little less external rotation. And you can either keep that left leg there, you can lengthen it long, or something I like to do is just kind of take it into a little bit of, kind of like a half happy baby position, but just there on the mat. Good, sole of the right foot should be towards the ceiling. Another breath in. And on the exhale, release that leg long, arms long. Breathe into the chest. Just feel the ring fingers reach towards the top of the mat. Feel the outer armpit, shoulder blades rotating up. And then bend the right knee. Left foot, left half happy baby. Grab the inside if you can. If you too much rotation, as always, grab the out. And the same options here for the foot. You can keep the knee bent. You can lengthen it long, or you can kind of bring it into that externally rotated half happy baby position. But take the left foot, sole of the foot towards the ceiling. Good. Take another inhale here. And exhale, release that. Take the legs off. Arms long. Now here, just lift the bend a little bit, lift the hips up, move the hips slightly towards the right side of your mat. Straighten the legs and just move the legs to the left side. I like to bring my thumbs together. Go ahead and do that if you can. If not, just reach forward, inhale. And on the exhale, just reach the fingers over towards the left side of the mat. If you hook the thumbs, you can get a little bit of an active assessed stretch here. You know, we're engaging the thumbs to, a little bit to hold on. But we're letting that right side of the body open up. Good. And exhale. Come back to center. Keeping the legs long, long breath. And on the exhale, move the hips more to the left. Heels go to the right. Inhale, grab each thumb, lift up towards the end of your mat. And on the exhale, side bend to the right. It's a nice little opening stretch. This is kind of a supine half moon, like you might get in a health practice. Inhale to that left side of the body for the rib cage. Feel everything nice open up. And exhale. Good. Come back to center. Square the hips up and bring the knees towards the chest. And nice and easy. Just rock back and forth a little bit and come up into a seated position, Sukhasana. Now I'm going to turn and face you. So here, take an inhale, arms up over that. Just really stretch the ring fingers up towards the ceiling. And on the exhale, bring the left hand to the right knee, plant the right hand behind you, just lift the chest. No need to kind of push yourself so hard. You can turn the head towards that shoulder in a manner that feels good on your body. But feel the spine lengthen. Feel the stability of the arm in the back. So you're using that arm to wake it up a little bit. And if it feels nice, you can get a little bit of leverage on that right knee. You take one more inhale, lift up. And exhale, twist a little more. Good. Come back to center. Bring that right hand down to the mat and then lift the left arm up and over towards the front of the mat, or side of the mat. Good. Still feel the stability in that right arm. So you can allow the left hip to lift up a little bit. Another inhale breath. And come back up. Take a breath of your inhale. And exhale. Inhale the arms up over the head. Bring fingers towards the ceiling. And exhale. Right hand, left knee. Left hand behind. If you can, have the fingers just pointing towards the back of the mat. Inhale, chest lifts. Feel grounded in the hips and feel grounded in that left hand behind you. Breathing into the spots. It might feel a little more restricted than those right side. Just try to breathe a little bit into that. And whatever feels good on the knee, twist a little bit more. Keep the head lifted. Keep the chest lifted. Another breath in. Back to center. Bring the arms up over the head and take a forward fold. Inhale, fingers stretch towards the front. And exhale. Good. Inhale, come back up. Let's bring the hands behind, just like we were, fingers towards the back. You don't have to take any weight up off the hips, but just press the hands down, lift the chest, and feel the collarbone broadening. I want to feel that by almost like trying to squeeze the shoulder blades together, trying to bring the back of the shoulders, just posterior deltoids, to bring the collarbone a little more broad. Good, take an inhale out here. And exhale. Good. Come back up. Bring the hips to your mat, and then find downward facing dog. Good. Now from downward facing dog, take an inhale. And on the exhale, bring the knees to the mat for all four position. Take an inhale. And on the exhale, take the right arm through. I like to bring the forehead to the mat. If you want to turn and look towards that right hand, you can. But if you want to stretch that left arm a little more forward, it might feel nice. Now, option here to stay a little more passive, or if you just want to try to press that arm a little bit into the mat, it might give you, not hard, just 5%, whatever, might give you a little bit of engagement. Sometimes just engaging the muscles just makes them feel better than just stretching alone. Another inhale. And come back up. All fours. Good. Inhale here. And an exhale. Do the same thing. Reach over towards the left side. Right arm and stretch long. Or towards the hand. And I like looking down, just kind of feel it gives me a little bit more mobilization into my neck. Good. Again, we can press that left arm into the mat a little bit. Feel engagement in the posterior shoulder. Good. Take another inhale breath. And then come back up. Come back to all fours. Now, two options here. We're kind of warming up the shoulders a little bit. So if you think a puppy pose would feel good, what that is just reach the arms forward. Just allow the chest to fall. If you feel like that feels good in your body, just go and find the puppy pose. If you feel like that might be a little too much on your back, on your shoulders right now, what you do is sit back into your child's pose, but reach the arms over towards the right. As you reach the arms over to the right, left hand on top of the right, and then take the hand, just put the fingers ever so slightly, just grab the mat. Good. If you're in that side bend, breathing into the right side of the body. But if you opt to stay in your puppy pose, just nice, easy breath. And don't feel like you have to stay here. If you want to switch it up, take both poses, like I'm actually doing it right now. Go for it. Good. Good. Okay, pelvic thrust. Come back for a second. All fours. And then let's take the same thing the other way. So sit back in your child's pose. Left hand to the right side of the mat, right hand on top. And then side bend. Puppy pose, as you can go back into the puppy pose. It feels good on your body. Good. No matter where you're at, come back to all fours. And then here, bring the hands to the mat, curl the toes, and lift hips back into downward facing dog. Take a breath in dog, nice and easy. Just fill up the lung. If you want to use the feet, use the hands to press the mat away. And the exhale, you can just bring the heels a little further to the mat. Inhale, lift the heels. And exhale, lift the hips. Bring the heels to the mat. Good. Inhale, lift the heels. Pressing through the arms. Pressing through the outer armpits. Nice and easy. Don't go so hard. And then exhale, lift the hip creases to the ceiling. Heels to the mat. Good. Take a breath here. Inhale, just walk the feet forward. Hands to the mat. So we're gonna go into Uttanasana. It's easy Uttanasana. So take an inhale, lift it up. If you have a block, it might feel nice. You bring the block in front of your face and press the mat away. If you don't have a block, you can always bring the hands to the shins. But try to get your body so it's almost in an upside down L position. So you wanna feel a little bit of engagement in the back muscles. Good. And not the muscles, you know, that might be sore, not your lats or anything, but some little bit deeper spinal stabilizer muscles that sometimes when we're sore, there's a little inflammation, just get a little bit inhibited. So think about lifting up a little bit. Think about drawing the belly button a little towards the spine. And then exhale, forward fold. Set the block in front if you have one. Now we'll move a little bit here. Nice and easy, no rush. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, slightly bend the knees, arms up towards the ceiling. Exhale, Tadasana. Good. Inhale, reach forward and up. Exhale, let's fold. Inhale, lift halfway up. And on exhale, open up the feet. Sit down, Malasana. Let's take an extra breath here in. And out. One more time in here. And exhale, forward fold. Inhale, sweep the arms up. And exhale, open up the feet. As you sit down, Malasana squat. Inhale, reach forward and up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Use your block again here if you have it, or your shins. Keep that up. Exhale. Stand up, inhale. Set the block aside. Exhale, forward, fold. Inhale, arms up, bend the knees, reach, stretch up. Exhale, Tadasana. I'm moving a little bit more here. Inhale, arms up. And exhale, fold. Inhale, lift the shoulders up. And on the exhale, Exhale, bring the hands to the mat. Step the right foot back, but keep the hands up on the mat as you take an inhale, lift the chest. Exhale, downward dog. I'll take an inhale here. And on the exhale, step the right foot forward, left knee down. Inhale, let's come up Anjanasana. Exhale, hands down, step the left foot forward. Inhale, lift up halfway. Exhale, let's fold. Inhale, bend the knees, sweep the arms up. Exhale, Tadasana. Inhale, arms forward and up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift the shoulders to the hip height. Hands on the shins or the block. Hold this for an exhale. Good. One more inhale here. And then exhale, bring the hands down to the mat and step the left foot back. Keep the hands on the mat. Inhale, chest lifts. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale into a plank. And if you want to, you can bring the knees to the mat, come all the way to the floor for cobra pose. Inhale, chest lift. Now take an extra breath here. And exhale. One more time, inhale. And exhale, lower down. You can go from the knees back to downward facing dog. Good, take an inhale. Exhale, step the left foot forward, right knee down. Inhale, reach the ring fingers towards the ceiling. Stay long, feel the length. Exhale, hands to the mat, right foot forward. Inhale, lift up shoulders to hip height. Now take hold this one twice. And exhale, think about rotating the pelvis a little bit, almost sticking the butt a little bit more out that way. Exhale. Inhale, squeeze the shoulder blades a little bit. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, bend knees, arms up. Bring fingers towards the ceiling. Exhale, into Tadasana. Inhale up. And exhale, we fold. Inhale, feel the back work. Stick the butt out, broaden the collarbone. Exhale, hands down, right foot back, hands on the mat. Inhale, chest lifts. Exhale, down dog. Inhale into plank, and again, come to the knees, nice and slowly lower down, but this time, arms by the body, palms down. Inhale, lift up, lift the feet up, squeeze the shoulder blades. We'll take an extra breath here too. Inhale here. Exhale. One more inhale. And exhale, hands to the mat. Again, come from the knees downward. Face it down. Set your arms over here just a little bit. Good. Downward dog. Take an inhale. And exhale. Inhale the right leg up, open up the hip, bend the knee. Good, inhale right knee a little higher. Exhale, step the right foot through, and this is coming to a crescent lunge. Now option here, you can bend the back knee a little bit, bring the hands to heart. Good, inhale at the chest lift. And exhale. Here, inhale, lift up. On the exhale, twist over towards the right and take a nice, easy twist. Actually, take the hand off, hand towards the mat. Good. If you want, you can keep that right hand on the knee, or if it's good, you know, put it up. Or if you kind of want to take your hand to the back, if you feel like that might feel good on your body, then always option to bring the back knee down. Good. heels. Exhale, settle the heels in. Inhale, left leg up and the knee, open up the hip. Left knee goes a little towards the ceiling. If it feels good, you can bring the heel up off the mat a little bit. Or if you want a little more of a calf stretch, bring the heel down. Good. Left knee comes through, and let's come into a crescent lunge. Hands to heart. Front knee can be bent. Or I'm sorry, front knee is bent. Back knee can be bent or straight. Good. Take an inhale here. And exhale. Bring the right hand to to the mat. Now left hand can stay there on the knee, or you can open it up. Hand to the back. An option to bring the knee down, whatever feels good. But just allow that right hand just to bear a little bit of the weight, so you want to feel grounded through both feet. Pushing through the shoulder blade. Good. Another inhale. Exhale, hands to the mat, downward dog. Inhale to plank, you bring the knees to the mat, roll all the way down for cobra pose again. So two blessings, inhale, lift up. And exhale, good. Inhale, lift up. And exhale, lower down, downward facing dog. Good, inhale, lift the heels. And exhale, settle the heels. Inhale, right leg up. And exhale, step the right foot through, left knee to the mat. And I'll turn and face you guys. Just take a seat in this pose. Loose. So here I want to inhale the arms up over the head. Right hand grabs the left wrist, or if you have your block, I feel nice to do this, grab the block. Hold it in the arms and just nice and easy. You can reach over. Keep the chest lifted. And even if you want to switch it up a little bit, you can grab the wrist. Do a little more active assisted, passive, or want to keep it engaged. Good. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, come back up. Let's bring our hands back to the mat and step the left foot forward. Inhale, halfway lift. If you have your blocks, so you can bring it to your mat. We want to find that L position. Stick the butt out. A couple of breaths here. And exhale. Inhale, squeeze the shoulder blades. Or again, hands can be on the shins. And on the exhale, grab the elbow creases. Nice, easy forward fold. Bend the knees. Good, let the head hang heavy. Good, one more breath. Release the hands. Inhale, arms up all the way over the head. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lift up halfway. Exhale, hands down, right foot back, right knee comes to the mat. We do the same thing, turn it this way. Inhale, arms up over the head. You can use your block if you have it. You want to do that. And side bend to the left. Keep the chest lifted. Keep the head stacked above the shoulders. Let's switch it up. You want to do a little more passive. Remember that breath, nice in breath through the nose and out through the nose. Good. Inhale here. And exhale. Let's come back up. Bring the hands back to the mat and then step back to downward facing dog. Now, if you want to actually downward dog, rock forward into a plank. Let's lower to the floor to come to the knees if you like. Two breaths, Shalabhasana. Inhale, lift the feet, chest, hands, head up. Now don't look towards the front. Think about looking down towards the mat but trying to bring the back of the neck a little closer to the ceiling. Squeeze the shoulder blades. Squeeze the toes. You can rotate the hips out a little bit. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, lower down. Downward dog. Come on, knees go. Good. Keeping that block handy. Take an inhale, lift the right leg up, bend the knee, open the hip real quick. Inhale, knee goes a little higher. And on the exhale, let's step the right foot through. And let's come into a Virabhadrasana 1. So in a Virabhadrasana 1, kind of the hips are faced a little bit that way. And our body's just angled, whatever, almost to that left front corner of the mat. If you have your block, inhale, arms up over the head. Good. Sink into that right knee a little bit, inhale. And I'm gonna keep that block in your hand. Open up like you're gonna go into a warrior two, but then take the arm block behind the body and so you just gotta grab it like that. This way, as you can see. So we're in that warrior two position. Let's squeeze the block a little bit. Open up the chest. Lift the head towards the ceiling. Good. Now if you can keep the block, keep it there. You can take a humble warrior with the block. Or if you just want to set the block aside, behind the hands, take it. Hands come to the mat, downward facing dog. Good. Last little thing. Inhale, left leg up, bend the knee, open the hip. Inhale, knee higher. Exhale, let's step the left foot through. Yeah, if you block, come into a Virabhadrasana 1. If you don't have a block where you don't feel like it right now, you can put the arms up over the head. But if you want to lift it up a little higher, bring fingers towards the ceiling, recommitting to that front leg. Good. The bread. And on the exhale, open up to that warrior two, take the block behind the body, press the block, open up the chest. So you can either do two things. You can either, you feel like squeezing a little bit, you can squeeze the block between the shoulder blades, or you can hold onto the block, and almost like you're trying to pull the block apart, open the chest a little bit more. Good. Inhale here. And an exhale. Release that. Hands to the mat, downward facing dog. Good. Inhale, lift the heels up. Exhale, lift the hips, press the hands, heels in the mat. Good, inhale, lift the heels. Exhale, press with the hands, lift the hips, heels come back down. Another breath in. And out. Now here, just inhale. Rock forward to a plank and just bring the knees to the mat. And however you want to get there, roll over to your back for bridge pose. Keep it nice and easy here. What I'm going to do, since we've had this block, we've been using it a little bit. If it feels good for you, open up a little bit further. You can bring the block between the knees and we're going to lift up. Or, if you feel like you want a little more in the arms, you take the blocks in the hand above the head and lift them like this. This feels better to me in my body, but options. Think about pressing that right big toe mount into the mat, not allowing the feet to roll out towards the side. We're going to press that inner part of the foot down into the mat. squeeze some glutes. If you're squeezing the block between the knees, do that. And squeeze the block a little bit between the hands, do that. Take an inhale. And exhale, lower back down. Set the block aside. Left leg goes long. Bring the right foot up. Sweep the bottom aside. Just grab the toe. Now, if you can't grab the toe, you can grab behind the knee. Take a nice, easy breath here. And then here, roll over to your left side. If you want to keep a hold of that toe, you can, but you want to bend that right knee and just bring the sole of the foot to the floor beside you. Now here, left hand is going to grab on to the top of that right ankle. Lay it back, take an inhale. Then on the exhale, just reach out towards the right side. Now if you like, you can reach straight out. I'm going to reach up at about, you know, a little bit of an angle there, diagonal. Feels good on my body, plus I got a wall here, so it's limiting my space. But as you're reaching through those right fingertips, with that left hand ever so slightly press into that right foot. But with that right foot, try to resist it, so try to lift that right foot into the hand. Take an inhale. Exhale, stretch a little bit more. And then come back up. Come back to center. Take a breath. Right leg long. Left leg goes up. Grab the toe, calf, hamstring, whatever works on your body. Feel so inclined and it feels good on your body. You can imagine you're trying to take that left hip down towards that right heel. That can open up a little space in that anterior part of the hip. Just allow, it's kind of like the ball ahead of that femur just to roll a little bit more in the socket. So. Good. Take an inhale. And the same thing. Bend the left knee. Roll over towards the right side, sole of the foot. It's facing perpendicular to the mat. Now, right hand grab the top of that left ankle and rotate over towards the left side. Now, take an inhale breath. And exhale, stretch through those fingertips. But with that right hand, press into the foot. But with the foot, try to resist it. Good. One more time again. And exhale, undo all of that. And let's just come back to where we started. So if you want to bend the knees, hands can be on the ribs, on the pecs, the floor beside you. I'm going to start again, palms up. And what feels might feel good to me is I'm going to put my palms up. I'm going to lift my hips up a little bit, squeeze my shoulder blades. And then with my feet, just press myself up towards the top of the mat. And to bring the hips back down. Good. Let's just take a couple minutes here. Nice, quiet shavasana. I'll remind us every minute on the minute. in it. Start to take a couple deeper breaths. And if you have the time, you want to stay a little bit longer in Shavasana, hit the video, stay a little bit longer. But for those of us who have to move on, let's move, roll over to our right side. And continue up into our hips, lift our hands, and come to a seated position. Hands can rest on the knees. Inhale, breath. As always, I'd like to thank you for practicing with me, and namaste.